I think too many hours of therapy are wasted, conversing primarily on an intellectual level about things the client already knows, for example, recounting past events, or what they think about themselves, or what they should do about their problems. I also think both client and therapist know when something more than that is happening, those moments when the therapy truly feels alive. But what can you do to bring about more of those moments? Okay, so now we're going to see about a 15-minute excerpt toward the end of my first online session with a client named Valeria. She's Italian, but living in Scotland, and this is an actual session. Up until this point, we cover a lot of what happens typically in a first session with me just getting to know her a bit. And she says she's seeking therapy because she wants to be able to connect more with herself.
I don't know if that still influences me at some level. Maybe with the research, you know? I'm like, okay, now I'm gonna try.
You will see when the world says no to you.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the phrase that sticks with you.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't remember a particular context. It's just right. Something I heard over and over.
Yeah. And what gets triggered inside you now when you say that? When that ring resonates in your mind, you will see when the world says no to you. I like how you're pausing now, because it seems, looks like you're
I'm trying to pick the right, I'm trying to connect truly with what I feel.
Yeah, I'm glad that you're taking the time to try to connect.
Yeah.
Because that's what you want to be able to do more.
Yeah.
In just 3 minutes, a lot has happened. I noticed that some affect started to well up inside her, and several times I deliberately and slowly repeat the phrase, "You will see when the world says no to you." I ask her what gets triggered for her, but I also take a deep breath and close my eyes, implicitly encouraging her to direct her attention inward. And then I direct and support her in pausing and taking time to attend to what she's feeling. In actuality, she was silent for about 20 seconds, which felt like a long time. But to me, it was a good sign that she was searching inside herself. In normal conversation, we often don't take time for silence and can even find it uncomfortable. But in therapy, we need to learn to sit with it, while at the same time assessing whether the client is able to use it productively.